Thank you. Transported to the upper room, to the foot of the cross, and to the place of the resurrection, the empty tomb. We begin the journey with the Lord. We walk with him as he journeys to the cross. And tonight, he gives us an example of great service, where he kneels and washes the feet of his disciples. We give thanks for that picture of service. And we also give thanks for the gift of the Holy Priesthood and of the Eucharist itself. So as we prepare to celebrate these sacred mysteries, let us call to mind and confess our sins. Lord Jesus, you are the Lamb who takes away our sins. You teach us how to love. Your death brings life to the world. God, who have called us to bless and to participate in this most sacred supper in which your only begotten Son, when about to hand himself over to death, entrusted to the church a sacrifice new for all eternity, the banquet of his love. Grant, we pray, that we may draw from so great a mystery the fullness of charity and of through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Instructions concerning the Passover meal. The Lord said to Moses and Aaron in the land of Egypt, "This month is to be the first of all the others for you, the first month of your year. Speak to the whole community of Israel and say, on the 10th day of this month, each man must take an animal from the flock, one for each family, one animal for each household. If the household is too small to eat the animal, a man must join with his neighbor, the nearest to his house, as the number of persons requires. You must take into account what each can eat in deciding the number of the animal. It must be an animal without blemish, a male 1 year old. You may take it from either sheep or goats. You must keep it till the 14th day of the month, when the whole assembly of the community of Israel shall slaughter it between the two evenings. Some of the blood must then be taken and put on the two doorposts and the lintel of the houses where it is eaten. That night, the flesh is to be eaten, roasted over the fire. It must be eaten with unleavened bread and bitter herbs. You shall eat it like this, with a girdle round your waist, sandals on your feet, a staff in your hand. You shall eat it hastily. It is a Passover in honor of the Lord. That night I will go through the land of Egypt and strike down the firstborn in the land of Egypt, man and beast alike, and I shall deal out punishment to all the gods of Egypt. I am the Lord. The blood shall serve to that you live in. When I see the blood, I will pass over you, and you shall escape the destroying plague when I strike the land of Egypt. This day is to be a remembrance for you, and you must celebrate it as a feast in the Lord's honor. For all generations, you are to declare it a day of festival forever. This is the word of the Lord.
And I see you, God.
Thank you. A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. This is what I received from the Lord, and in turn passed on to you, that on the same night that he was betrayed, the Lord Jesus took some bread, and thanked God for it, and broke it, and said, "This is my body, which is for you. Do this as a memorial of me." In the same way, he took the cup after supper and said, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Whenever you drink it, do this as a memorial of me." Until the Lord comes, therefore, every time you eat this bread and drink this cup, you are proclaiming his death. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. It was before the festival of the Passover, and Jesus knew that the hour had come for him to pass from this world to the Father. He always loved those who were his in the world, but now he showed how perfect his love was. They were at supper, and the devil had already put it into the mind of Judas Iscariot, son of Simon, to betray him. Jesus knew that the Father had put everything into his hands, and that he had come from God and was returning to God. And he got up from table, removed his outer garment, and taking a towel, wrapped it round his waist. He then poured water into a basin and began to wash the disciples' feet and to wipe them with the towel he was wearing. He came to Simon Peter, who said to him, "Lord, are you going to wash my feet?" Jesus answered, "At the moment you do not know what I am doing, but later you will understand." "Never," said Peter, "you shall never wash my feet." Jesus replied, "If I do not wash you, you can have nothing in common with me." "Then, Lord," said Simon Peter, "not only my feet, but my hands and my head as well." Jesus said, "No one who has taken a bath needs washing. He is clean all over. You too are clean, though not all of you are." He knew who was going to betray him. That was why he said, "Though not all of you are." When he had washed their feet and put on his clothes again, he went back to the table. "Do you understand," he said, "what I have done to you? You call me Master and Lord, and rightly so I am.
If I then, the Lord and Master, have washed your feet, you should wash each other's feet. I have given you an example so that you may copy what I have done to you.
My gospel of the Lord.
All through Lent, we have been thinking about themes of mercy. And today is, you could say, the day of mercy par excellence. Love one another. That is why this day is called Maundy Thursday. The Maundy refers to the command of Jesus to love one another, mandatum novum, a new commandment. We can think this way today. Love one another, serve one another, have mercy on one another. To love one another is to seek the good of the other person. If we love the other person, we want that person to be fully alive in a way that responds to God's love. To serve the other person is to put our good desires for them into action. It's a nice thing to pray for those who have nothing, but if we never help them, if we never help them to have something, then our love is just false. If we leave others powerless and always able to be exploited, then our love is false. To serve others means to put our own lives at risk by doing actions that promote the good of others. To have mercy on the other person is not to judge them, but only to work for their good. So many cultures and people believe that if a person makes a mistake, they must pay for it. Our God says something quite different. He does not do that to us. Yes, he wants us to learn from our mistakes, but he is always there to help us and always has mercy on us. Do. Today, as always, we are brothers and sisters in the Lord. And so, my brothers and sisters, today we celebrate God's love for us. If we are not willing to live that same love for others, to serve others, to have mercy on others, then we have not yet truly known God's love for us. And so let us not fool ourselves about that. Let us seek the living God today and give thanks to our Lord Jesus Christ, who shows us the love God has for us. He did not need to wash anyone's feet, and yet he did so. He did not need to leave us himself, yet he did so in the Eucharist. And so today, and through all these holy days, may our hearts have some small glimpse of his love, that we can let that love transform us and help us love one another and all those that we meet.
Those now who have offered or been pressing into having a foot wash, please come and sit on the black seats.
We have
invites us to his supper. And so let us pray for that particular before.
We ask for a spirit of service. Jesus the Master washed the feet of his followers. May we learn from him that God's way demands our service of others, in the community and in the church. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for those called to ministry in the churches. May all who are called to ministry in the churches be wise leaders in the community, eager to share God's word with their fellow servants in the church. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We ask for a renewal in our following of Jesus. Jesus gave us a new commandment, to love one another as he loved us. May we deepen our desire to live that commandment, that people everywhere may recognize us as followers of Christ. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for a desire to be broken for others. May the broken bread and the outpoured wine be symbols of God's people, willing to be broken and poured out for the service of the world. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Hasten the day when people will come from north and south, from east and west, to rejoice at the eternal banquet of heaven, where you are Lord forever and ever.
Thank you.
and sisters, that this my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands. Praise the Lord.
Grant us, O Lord, we pray that we may participate worthily in this mystery. For whenever the memorial of the sacrifice is celebrated, the work of our redemption is accomplished through Christ our Lord.
But for their merits and prayers in all things, we may be defended by your protection.
Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, let it go on with family, which we make to you as we observe the day on which our Lord Jesus Christ handed on the mysteries of his body and blood for his disciples to celebrate. Order our days in peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation, and counsel man the flock of those who have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it becomes for us the body and blood of your beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer for our salvation and the salvation of all, that is today, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven to you, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat it, for this is my body, which will be given up. He said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sin. And this be memory. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you continue to sanctify them, fill them with your life, bless them, and bestow them upon us.
Thank you.
So may we enjoy this banquet from all eternity. Will it ever end forever and ever?
Thank you.
parted my arms among them, and for my rest every day I